We all know right now in Haiti, 10% of the population controls 90% of the wealth. For everyone in my comment section, the easiest solution to this problem is violence. I often come across the phrase, coupe dead, belay kai, which seems to be our solution for a lot of things, but unfortunately have not worked, ever since the revolutionary days. If history could teach us anything, it's that this thinking is the reason why Haiti is in the situation it's in today. Our history is drenched with massacres of dark-skinned Haitians against mulattoes, and mulattoes against dark-skinned Haitians, and because of that, we as a nation haven't been able to get anywhere. In order to make a change, in this series, I'm going to expose all these massacres in an attempt for us to learn, heal, and forgive one another, and maybe this way, we can build the future of Haiti together. On March 1, 1847, General Faustin Soloque was voted into power by the Mulatto Senate and took the presidency oath. The next day, General Soloque was dark-skinned and well-built and fit the description of a ruler. At first, Soloque was malleable and agreeable. However, within a short period of time, Soloque surprisingly rejected his backers, which was primarily the mulattoes, and began to consolidate himself as the absolute ruler of Haiti. He organized a private militia, the Zinglins, and proceeded to arrest, kill, and burn out anyone who opposed him, especially mulattoes. Soloque's power consolidation saw an increase in racial discrimination in favor of Haiti's black population, including a massacre of the mulattoes in Port-au-Prince on April 16, 1848. Most of the mulatto population went into hiding while Soloque seized properties, gold, and anything valuable that was left behind. Soloque placed heavy restrictions towards all opposition, and a wave of violence used against potential rivals led to numerous murders. Soloque even went as far as killing Jean-Jacques Dessalines' son, Caesar Dessalines, which was a close compatriot to him. In 1858, a revolution against Soloque was led by the mulatto General Fabre Geffert, Duc de Dabarra, and in December of that year, Geffert defeated Soloque's army and seized control of most of Haiti. General Faustin Soloque was a disgrace to the nation of Haiti. Because of his hatred, he created a division between the blacks and the mulatto Haitians. This division would follow us throughout history and will continue to do so unless we put an end to it. Now, what we all need to understand is, the Republic of Haiti belongs to both dark-skinned Haitians and mulatto Haitians. Let's stop making the same mistakes our forefathers made. Let us all seize our own destiny and build a better Haiti together.